Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to some of you, and peace out to the rest of you. You know who this is, Blackheart, coming black at you again, signing black in, asking you to hit the share button, and then to decide if you want to hit the like or the subscribe button. As I was writing this message yesterday, I did not know that Real Talk 100% had already, that's the name of her channel, that she had already recorded something. I was completely unaware of that. She hadn't actually done so at that point, but I was writing this, and then I found that only 5 hours ago, and it's almost 9 a.m. At the time, in my local time zone where I live, it's almost 9 a.m. For many of you, it's midnight or right before midnight. She streamed this 5 hours ago, and it's only gotten 13 views. This needs to be known. It is her video, What Being Lame Means in African-American Culture, LOL. I wouldn't take her point as far as she's taken it, but what I would, I was writing yesterday this message to address exactly that. The thing to remember about being select or non-select is that, frankly, each man is categorized as one or the other by a dysfunctional demographic of women from the beginning. And this is in the context of both black and white Western cultures. But this also happens with other Western or Westernized communities. My concern, of course, is black folks, and then then other communities of color in order of their just treatment towards us black folks. And lastly, my negative concern is for the white Western uncivilization. The words negative concern mean that I hope that frankly they fall under the weight of the problems that they caused us. But though my vitriol is for them, the fact is that our communities are dysfunctional, and yes, the women are worse than the men in the African-American community. Based on how bad they are regarding men outside of friendship, and I'm not even calling men angels, but based on how bad they are regarding men outside of friendship, because they do make very excellent and loyal friends if they really mean it. The fact is that their ideas of select and non-select are not only immaterial, but actually opposite to what is normal outside of the physical. You can understand why they would physically prefer what they physically prefer, but for any real women in non-Western cultures that can last for generations, the Western woman is self-destructive as hell in her preference for bad dudes. The Western white cave bitch is a pretender to her. And the Western black bitch to her is outright and brazenly ratchet and dysgenic in her preferences. Physically, even Western women make sense in their preferences as far as even non-Western women are concerned, but their expectations, which differ from the preference itself, are unrealistic. We may prefer women with the bodies of strippers, but we don't necessarily expect them to have much going on upstairs. And why would we expect it? You don't find that same critical thinking with women in the West. Western women do not factor in limited resources when judging men, only when judging themselves. Non-Western women in general know that to judge men without factoring in limited resources is a setup for disappointment and maybe even insanity later on in life. This is still changing, and even in the DR and Brazil, which are black American men's most favorite locations to find feminine women, feminism is creeping in and affecting women's relationships with the local men. These women are harsh with local men and feminine and flirtatious with Yankee brothers who have greenbacks with him, and therefore they are nothing special to me either. Most of the IG models in the US that are so fine on camera and not even that fine are not feminist when a man is loaded and has the appearance they want. Well, when you are a black man and you've got the appearance that these women want in Latin America, which is understandable, but then they also are looking at the greenbacks, you become Dan Bilzerian to them. So they're no longer feminist. Dan Bilzerian in the US doesn't see the feminist in the women who deal with him, but best believe all of them have been rabidly feminist, foaming at the mouth, maybe even misandric, to some normal men around them who were interested in them and even who were not interested in them. Simply put, their obedience and compliance and even femininity are for sale, and thus I understand the motive for men to go to these locations, but I also understand that the majority of their women aren't worth a damn under the surface either. Now, I wanted to make sure and get some feedback. Now I got it from Latin American men to find this out. They're not aiming their venom at us. These women don't aim their venom at us like they do with their own men and like the Western bitch aims it at us. Actually, I see Latin American women as Western women, but I understand that not everyone else does. And I also understand that it changes from city to city. But that said, let me point out that even to be select in the eyes of Western black women, or cave bras for that matter, means that you're probably in good shape physically, but that mentally there's something wrong with you. And that's really the formula. See, with Western black women, it's even more brazen. You got to be more in shape, but mentally more jacked up. And this is why I favor information man's terms, NCR and CR. Collectively respected and NCR, non-collectively respected, or CNR, collectively non-respected. And this is because it's really just an issue of respect. But you see, respect in our communities comes for very foolish reasons. Information Man pointed this out in a group, and I have to agree. It ain't just Hood Sapphires and Bonquishas that select men this way. 92 Octanes, referred to as such by Ron Wills and later by BGS, want the same guys, to which even my mother would now confess. So frankly, when Ron Will said that non-select men in the community aren't more intelligent than the select men, I would agree, but for different reasons than he would. See, being select in our community means that you have to have something wrong upstairs or something missing. A man in our community is unappealing to a visually appealing woman if he has nothing wrong mentally. He can't necessarily have Down syndrome and be mentally retarded, but at the end of the day, he can't be functioning at his full capacity. But see, while our women are avoiding men in whom they perceive intelligence, they're actually choosing men who are still intelligent, but they're doing it accidentally, because a wise man can play a fool, but the fool can't pretend to wisdom. Thus, many men in our communities have hidden their intelligence from these women so that they can be chosen sexually. And when these women can't trick them into commitments when they have other options and find sisters who weren't intimidated by the intelligence they didn't even know he had, they get upset because he wasn't supposed to be that smart anyway. When he is, it's on to the next one from whom he hides his brains and shows his muscles or tattoos and goals. Because again, his manhood to them can't be shared between his muscles and brains in the minds of the Western woman. It can't be in his brains. It has to be in his body only. And only street smarts are allowed. Frankly, if he's smart enough to never go to jail or prison, then he's suspected of either being innocent and pretending not to be, or ratting out others. In a dysfunctional context like this, it's actually not saying anything about you mentally to be called select. It's an insult. But you might be selected because they don't know about your intelligence, but them, you being selected in their eyes can't be a compliment to you. For this reason alone, a man must understand that for black American, black British, black Canadian, and even some island women to consider him select, he's actually a CR man among them, which means he's an NCR or a CNR man anywhere else in communities that are less broken. Now, every community ain't unbroken, but in communities that aren't so broken, he would not be select. For the same reasons he select in our community. We might not be the most broken people in the world, but believe you me, we are broken and we are backwards. Now don't get me wrong, hybristophilia, I mean, I just now said hybristophilia and infatuation with thugs is present in all societies with bad neighborhoods and even societies without them. But there are few places where the majority of women prefer thugs and guys of low intelligence beyond the streets and the gang environments. Gangsters fornicate in many parts of the world. In Somalia, pirates got married easily and to the most beautiful women too. But the cultures aren't defined by this existence of this trend. And it doesn't shape the genes of the entire generations. Only in the West does this happen. Only in the West is it okay for women to take responsible men who think and use their brains for other than gang business and make them pay more and work harder than guys whose brain power is dedicated to playing in gang business. Only in the West is it okay to give the drawers up to the drummer of a band that's not going anywhere. Just have him cream pie your cervix for no cost at all. Then try to rush into a marriage with a man that's not the same type, so that he thinks the baby is his and then raises it. Only in the West is a woman actually ridiculed by other women for marrying a responsible guy when she's young and bypassing the whole phase and doing so while she's in shape and attractive, because she's expected to waste those years on men who sleep around and don't commit. Only in the West normal men considered to be so low that they don't deserve to be with an attractive woman who doesn't bring baggage, kids, STDs, a used up badge, and a plan to leave him and take all she can anyway. Only in the West are normal men seen as being that low, to the extent that a woman who doesn't agree with this view that they're so low is ridiculed by other women as a fool and a lame. Just like men are considered lames for being normal, women who see normal men as having any value are also considered lame by other women. We all know about price discrimination, and while that can exist anywhere, it is only mandated culturally by women in the Western nations. And this is wherein lies the difference. You go to the DR or to Brazil, then women that don't want to do this stuff are not considered lame by other women. So how do NCR men in black communities answer this extra charge, this penalty fee for who we are not? Well, you tell the Western woman in simple terms, I'm going over there for more value to my dollar since it has to cost me anyway. Now, she might be treating me better for real. She may be treating me better because of the exchange rate between our currencies, but she's treating me better for less than you ever would. Not only am I doing this, but I'm introducing other brothers to do the same so that in the end, you will only have two choices. Go to the select dude, the CR, for what you need outside of the penis, or go to the man of her nation from which she comes from for what you need outside of penis. I'm marrying this Filipina, or maybe I'm only marrying her in the church or in the masjid, not in front of the state, but I'm gonna be with this Filipina woman. So either you go to Junebug, tattoo, snake eyes, Uzi, and felony, or you can get you a man from the Philippines for what you need, but you can't come to me for what you need, nor brothers like me. And since those men know that you're not worth it because they've seen on TV how you act and what you say, you'll have to be a green card and passport vehicle to them just to keep them for a few years until they get naturalized. Deal with it. The only way to avoid these options is to be, to me, what you're willing to be to tattoo in them while we're both young and look your best. We're both young and you look your best, and you be to me what you're willing to be to Snake Eyes and Uzi and Felony, or I'm going to go over there to Mexico. She's going to treat me well. You, on the other hand, either lower your price and charge Junebug the price so that I can tap it, or you go to Junebug for all your needs, or you can go to Mexico and find you one of the men there for all your needs. And really, the only thing they would see you as is a green card vehicle for now and a passport naturalization vehicle later on. You would not get a price raised out of me for less in exchange. And since I'm Muslim, I'm not even going to tell guys to date. I'm only going to tell them to marry, even if it's only in a religious institution and not in front of a courthouse, but to only do so to women whose own men these same Western thoughts don't want. And tell them why. Encourage other men to do the same. This is why I said passporticons leave loudly, because see, these women, the one hope that they might have is that they'll tell their daughters, I screwed up, and that's why ain't no men out here for you. You're going to have to go abroad, and hopefully you don't mess it up like me. See, we got to encourage other men to do the same so that the thoughts only have those options. Don't worry about the good women in the West, because they already found their commitments and their husbands, and they don't always know what's going on in the lives of the thoughts anyway. They will have better options for better outcomes because they made better choices out the gate. It's their deformed friends and classmates who are going to suffer, and that is perfectly all right, because they were not only abnormal compared to most of the world's women, but they insisted on being abnormal to begin with because it was cool, and to be normal was lame. Because of their definitions of morality and right and wrong, the bad ones gonna deserve this, and the good ones already sidestepped it. I hope this has been a benefit. Black Heart signing, Blackout. Assalamu alaikum.